Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about an ancient Iranian house known as Abbasian House, which was bought 100 years ago by a famous businessman known as Abbasian. This house has 5,000 square meters floor area and 7,000 square meters as its infrastructure. The building process began in 1829 and it took 20 years to be completed. This house has three main sections: external part, internal part, and courtyards. Internal section consisted of living room with two floors, two rooms which are designated to worship, and summer resorts. Living room was used for receiving guests and family gathering. Nonetheless, there are two floors in this part. The upper floor was used by women and down floor by men during winter season. Internal section also has some balconies that were used during spring season. This part has a courtyard with pool and flower beds that double down the beauty of this place. Porch is located at the front of the living room and it's also used during spring season. Living room has unique patterns on the walls. Most of them look like sun, moon, and stars. The doors of the living room open and close vertically, and their upper part has two layers. This room was used to receive special guests and hold special ceremonies such as wedding. External part consisted of winter resort, main living room, conference hall, and mirror room. In winter resort, there are some balconies overlooking the courtyard, just like the internal section. These rooms were built around the courtyards are resistant to wind and sandstorms of desert areas. The difference between internal and external part is that external part has more sophisticated architecture and it was used for receiving visitors and holding business meetings. Conference hall has a lofty ceiling and a perforated dome to create air circulation and work as a skylight too. This part also has two floors and was used for holding rituals and religious ceremonies. Porch area has special patterns on its ceiling and located next to the conference hall and was used during spring season. In that time, architectures used two main colors in creating motifs on the ceilings. This method creates a noticeable contrast and embossed patterns would become more conspicuous. Mirror room belonged to landlord and has mirror tiles. Interestingly, there's a small door behind this room that leads directly to the outside of the house. Another attraction of mirror room is that when you stand in front of one of the doors, you will see the repetition of the door frame. It is as if you are witnessing an image in parallel mirrors, and this repetition has created a spectacular sight. In that time, entrance doors created with a short height. In that way, when a visitor wanted to enter the room, they had to bend. This pose looked like bowing and was considered as a respectful sign for the landlord. Also, the base of the door is higher to avoid entering dust and insects into the room. Ceilings with carved patterns in external section is ubiquitous, especially in the main living room. I should mention that most of main living rooms have five doors with colorful windows, which were built out of carved woods. In that time, ceilings has mirror tiles that, aside from aesthetic aspect, they reflected the light, especially during the night time, to make the inside of the room lighter. As you can see, the ancient Iranian architecture is focused on internal decoration. Keep in mind that these kinds of houses have no windows that open towards outside of the building. Instead, we have colorful windows inside of every part. Courtyard consisted of summer resort, pools, flower beds, basement, laundry room, kitchen, and cistern. Since the city of Kashan is located in the vicinity of the desert, architects try to exploit of architecture and adjust the temperature of the building by designing a pool space. The presence of pool and water circulation channels around the rooms, as well as channels connected to the wind tower, create a pleasant atmosphere, which is quite noticeable compared to other parts of the building. In the basement, we have channels for guiding water to other rooms in order to make them cooler. These channels are insulated with such precision that they do not have any water leakage and do not damage the foundation of the building. This place is known as a room with a pool that has a skylight surrounded with a stone banister to make the basement lighter. Another attractive part of this section is its doors and windows, which are made with delicate art. This means that glue and nails are not used in their construction, and the pieces of wood are inserted into each other. During that time, the house was supposed to be built lower than the level of the adjacent alley. This feature got the water pressure facilitated in order to flow easily in the whole building. In other part of the basement, there is another part for nuclear family with unique patterns, as well as subsidiary parts next to it for saving perishable foods. The air in the basement is cool due to factors such as the special architecture of the basement, wind towers, water channels, and also the level difference between basement and the alley. One of the reasons for the fame of this historic mansion is its decorations. This house has a special embossed patterns on each wall. There are several fireplaces in rooms with some patterns look like plants and birds, which make this house outstanding in comparison to other houses. In that time, carvings on the walls represented the occupation of the owner, and because the proprietor was a businessman who traded crystal candlesticks, you can see some patterns look like candlestick. Laundry room is located in the underground floor, and it has its own channels to supply water for washing clothes. Kitchen has some stoves for cooking bread and food, and some places to hold clay dishes. Cistern has its own well and special channels, that all of them are located in a covered area to be away from the sunlight and remain cool for drinking. At the main entrance, we have a long covered hall with a mild slope that leads to the vestibule, which has a stable for beasts of burden. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.